trying to find some space on this side of the map. Jasper is going to go down. It looks like ARG is in there mixing it up with them right now.
Yeah, it's a breach going on here.
So it's a big breach. CZ, Nawin still up. Planet is playing the front position for ARG. It looks like Sara and Indy, they're not coming out to help out right now.
They need to help Planet. Planet is all by himself in that little shack, as we can see. One nade in there. Wait, he actually ran out now, so it's more safe.
It looks like they're getting a smoke ready. They want to try to get Jasper back up right now. So CZ throws the additional smoke down.
He got stolen.
You can see the green pop. The steel comes out, but Planet doesn't have a lot of options. CZ and Nawin, I guess, are in a better spot, but not by much. Smoke wall coming out for the rest of ARG. They're going to move their way in all the way up in that smoke wall. So it looks like a breach is only a second or two away.
Here we go.
Going around to the side. They look like they want to try to get in. Sarah playing the back. He goes up on the ramp, makes the jump. The breach should be happening at any moment. They'd have to figure out which door Nawin is covering, and they want to try to come in, split two door, two in one, and one in the other.
Where are you gonna hold? What are you gonna do? Here we go.
He comes in, he starts to spray. He goes down very, very fast.
One down, two down.
He goes to the third. That is it. PLM holds the line with two players alive. It was a much needed push by All Rejection Gaming, but they could not execute.
It came down to the crossfire that they were holding, and CC, he was running around trying to make them go for him.
If they had found a way to come in two and one on different doors, that might have gone differently, but they stacked up as three. They weren't prepared for the crossfire. It cost them big time. Yasha taking some shots over here at SSG. We do see another circle. Whoop, another circle does come out, and it's gonna go farther north this time, so it is gonna cause even more chaos as teams look to relocate. You'll start to see that happening. Unique Yasha up on the hill has had SSG in his sights for a minute now, Frost.
Yeah, and I mean, with the new circle as well, we saw that the circle went for it south last time. It was a hard shift, and most of the teams, they were already on the north side. Now the circle went back towards there, so most of the teams, they already got a good positioning inside.
Yeah. Going to the south was tough. We're eating up towards the north now, and you know it's going to be difficult for the teams that had gone south. Queso relocated towards the south that time, and now they're going to have to sort of slip back up to the north. So that's what you get with those hard shifts. It can really throw off your intentions.
You know what? Looking at the map there, Zooms, he's been swimming for like 5-6 minutes. Yeah. I'm curious, how has he not frozen to death yet in that ice cold water?
I mean, had PLM gotten wiped out in that push by ARG, it would have been great news that he was out there. At this point, though, I don't know what his play is. Come in and give Queso a point, or just allow the currents to take you.
Well, they could make a push towards Queso, because Queso is kind of getting pinched between them.
That's true. Nobody looks towards the water. Nobody ever expects you to come out of there, right? So maybe he comes out, maybe he gets a knock, and they push. All Rejection Gaming was knocked out, so they will be officially eliminated. Three teams out right now. RRQ, Athena, All Rejection, and the Brazilian Killers leaving. 69 team down to one. Let's take a look at XQF as they push up on SSG. Space Station Gaming, XQuest going head-v-head. Space Station Gaming hasn't had a chance to breathe in this match, Frost.
No, everybody's on them, but it also comes down to where they're playing from. It looks like they're trying to go for kind of positioning where everybody wants to be at.
Absolutely. So we got Jimmy very low and slow inside of this grass, this wooded area, a little bit tricky to fight in. It's got the grass density a little bit lower than a Sandhawk, but it's still very difficult to spot your opponents. Lots of rocks, lots of trees, so it's going to be very important to get their information. Meanwhile, 69 team Groza also moving in from the north.
Yeah, and it could be a freeway battle. Juicy actually going down to a Molotov from Jimmy.
Ooh, that should open up some options. The Molly goes out there. Burn, baby, burn. XQF, again, shows us why they are so confident as a team. Space Station Gaming, completely eliminated.
They are gone for this game, and looking at it, we still got 12 teams, 39 people alive. We're going into phase number 6, and it's still a lot of people alive. Look at that new circle.
Yeah, Yasha looking to get a spin, stop there, but that's the problem with SSG. They were all bunched up. The Molotov was just too strong. They had no other options. Yasha and the rest of his team have been on the move ever since they took fire from Bigatron early on, and again, they have to relocate. They've been chasing this circle nonstop. It looks like Soul, the guys who we said have trouble with rotations in cars, found themselves a good spot because they are right smack in the middle of this circle, and they've got GC Busan right next to them across the road. Those two teams have a tall order of defending their space against what's going to be an onslaught with 12 teams and 39 players still alive.
Yeah, no rotation for Soul this time. The question is, are they better at holding it down?
We'll find out. I mean, you got to be good to get here. These guys have the skill. They're starting to get over that travel. They felt like they came alive earlier today in a couple of games. This could be their big moment. Meanwhile, Queso, who's had the map circle for a long time, loses it aggressively, and it will have to make a hard transition. Here's what we're talking about. Soul Gaming, very nice little spot here. They've got those two compounds and walls around them. That's important to note because they're very strategically valuable.
What's on the camera now is basically the next circle itself. And as you can see, there is two compounds. Both of them are taken right now. And we still have 12 teams alive. The question is, how many breaches are we going to see here?
We're going to probably see a lot of smashes into Soul. They have to be ready because whichever of those two compounds gets to the next circle becomes king of the hill, basically. So everyone's going to want to get inside of those walls. The upside for Soul, those walls are going to slow down potential breaches, so they have
a
chance to defend
one.
Themselves.
Ooh.
The first one is here. Unique crashes right into it.
Soul
looks like they want to play. We're watching it. We're waiting. They go ahead and burn down one and two. Ronok and Viper putting in some serious work. Meanwhile, GCB defending against the Queso push. They come around. The Ghillie's not going to help you right now. Mystic trying to burn him down. Rose down to just a couple of HP. Tries to flip out the heal, and that is exactly what we said would happen. Soul fighting Unique. GCB holding off Queso.
Here comes up Esports.
They want to get involved. Rose taking more damage. Heal after heal. Hope after hope. Can he stop them? Meanwhile, Ryzen goes down to Ming from ELG, who's pushing into... Wow. Oh, Unique goes down. The stop. Soul managed to stop them on their crash. Scarge Black also eliminated in the chaos. Queso still fighting. Top Esports has shown up and wants to get involved. Ayala has to dive behind the UAZ and try to survive, but he gets knocked. And Bigatron Esports, by the way, out as well.
Everybody's dying right now, and look at this. Who's gonna win this fight? All three teams are still alive here. Busan, Top Esports, and Queso. Queso down to one player right now,
It's a tough compound. It's like a compound within a compound because of the way the walls are arranged here. Mystic trying to fight off Top Esports while GC Busan waits to see who survives the first fight before they take on the next boss. Literally, it's a multi-stage invasion. This dungeon is impossible to breach. Groza sees Cat, catches him from behind.
Can he find more?
That's terrible news for XQuest. They've got to turn and figure out where this snake from behind has bit them in the heel.
But Groza goes down, and that's all for them for this game. XQF, they do lose one, though.
That's a huge, huge problem for XQuest. They have a long way to go, and now they only have three. The shift comes in. It goes away from Soul. GCB gets the compound, but now they have to stop every single adventurer trying to find their way in.
The question is now, are Top Esports going to try to push the compound, or are they going to work together with GC Busan and hold everybody else off?
Well, the Top Esports needs to get inside. Look at the wall structure of this overview right here. The compound is inside of other walls. You have a very good cover spot. Those boxes make sight lines very difficult to deal with. And where Top Esports is declined, right? It's lower than the rest of the compound. So there's just so much to deal with in terms of the geography of this compound.
But the thing is, they don't need to engage the fight right now. They could just hold their west side, making sure that no one can come in from that side, and then they can push it really, really late because they are just on the edge of the circle.
I like what GC Busan's doing. Rose is in charge of gathering information. He'll call his team if Top Esports pushes. The rest of the team is watching across the road to make sure they hold off anybody who tries to push in on them. Rose, Yunjun doing a great job of holding. Mystic, the magic boy, by himself trying to hold. It looks like they're right on top of each other. He gets
one
down. He's inside the smoke, but now everyone from Top Esports knows where he is.
Oh, he gets another one!
The second one, and the flush! That's the double. Mystic gonna be excited about that one. Top Esports, their heads are spinning.
They're
not sure where the bullets are coming from at this point.
Mystic, can he get a third one? He gets a third one!
Mystic is on fire as he takes out Top Esports. The second place team is falling to Queso for the knockout of top competitor for the second time in this match.
No one saw that coming. Busan, they now have a really good compound almost for themselves because they have Mystic from Team Queso helping them out.
RRQ, third place dies to Queso. We see Top Esports, second place dies to Queso. Can Mystic do it? Can he go the distance? We'll wait and watch as we go to the first place team, XQuest, Cool Boy. Keeping it low, keeping it slow, trying to get himself into that circle. But Jimmy's up in the mess.
Everybody's putting out smokes right now. They are crawling. They are trying to make their way in. Jimmy, as you said, inside the zone. Cool Boy, not inside the zone.
Mystic going for the first stage. The blue tick is real. He's gonna have to pop lock and take off running. Get himself inside if he can. He does get low and slow as he waits it out. ELG coming from the far side. Soul is up there on the edge as well. They're inside of the smoke. The fight breaks out. It looks like Soul. Mortal ends up going down. They're down to one, two players, I believe. We got ELG with four. But they're outside the circle. They're gonna have to make a wide open push to try to get in here.
Soul needs to try and maybe try to hold it down a little bit better. They are in the new circle, but it's gonna be rough with all these teams all around them right now.
Yun Jun knows where Jimmy is. He heard the crash. He knows that someone's in there. I don't know if he has the grenades to take him out. He's gonna wanna do that. Mystic, remember, still on the outside, causing problems. Rose has been assigned to keep his eyes on him and make sure he doesn't come in. Jimmy trying to gather information. Justice now is right outside of Jimmy's thing, compound, waiting for him to peek. Gets the smoke. He's trying to trigger him. He's trying to scare him into running out. They go for the breach. They start the pre-fire.
Shotgun.
It's an exchange, but it should be okay. Was that a shotgun?
That was a Spaz 12.
What a boss. So the smoke goes off, and that means they knew that they'll have the space to get the res. Meanwhile, Soul taking some serious fire out from the outside. Elite Gaming absolutely lighting off our Indian team as they try to hide between their homemade fortress.
That's the problem of being in the center of the circle. It's gonna be so hard.
XQuest was eliminated during that fight. The number one team is out. Looks like ELG gonna continue to crawl forward here, trying to get themselves into the mix. They've been doing a good job, but the blue is at their back, and GC Busan has something to say about how to play this one. We wondered if they'd thrive on Vikendi like last time. Looks like they are.
They could do it again. They could get another win on Vikendi, but it's not over yet. And hold your horses, because Mystic is still alive.
He's alive, but he should be dying to the blue. He's just spamming first aid, so don't expect him to get involved with this one. It's down to Nova, GC Busan, and Elite Gaming on the crawl. Want to make the play. Yun Jun gets a nice spray down. That'll be the end of Bezai out of Elite. Nova trying to push forward, and it looks like GC Busan just gets this map.
GC Busan is now down to two members, so Rose is knocked, but Justice, he might be able to get the rest. They are inside the smoke, and a new smoke is coming out for him as well.
Remember, Elite Gaming does have one down. They're probably not going to be able to get that res as they can't stand up. They're out in the wide open. Yun Jun out in front of the rest of his team. He ends up going down. So that means we've got Mystic from Queso. Nova has two players left alive on the outside. Elite Gaming with three and one knock. And Team GC Busan with Justice and Rose, the only two remaining members after that wicked fight with XQuest.
Now the question is, who's gonna make the first move? Who's gonna try to take control? Nova, they got a good compound, but a two Dacia fortress to play with here.
Mystic finally succumbs to the blue. The injury's too great, the time too long, but at the cost of so many top teams. Nova tried to make the play. They stand up. We see Justice go down. That'll be GC Busan down to one. Leader on the push. Stands up, wants to push up on Nova. They've got one knocked and one standing.
AY is
down. ELG coming aggressive.
ELG.
Inside. Bronco knows where he is. He opens.
He's going for it.
And they will take the win. Elite Gaming, who had zero cover when that chaos broke out, played it slow, played it low, and stayed ahead of the blue to glow at the end.